group wants to help students navigate things like time management, stress, and anxiety, along with other issues they may face while distance learning. And this group knows a thing or two because they are students themselves. In this story that is positively San Diego, ABC 10 News reporter Vanessa Paz shows us how they have already helped dozens of students.
This group of rising juniors at Del Norte knows navigating middle and high school can be hard, and doing it virtually can be even harder.
Staying alone in the house and social distancing has made it in the way that it's really hard to hang out with your friends. But with this platform, they're allowed to, like, you know, come and interact with their community and learn from their community's experiences.
They've been at it since July, helping peers across San Diego, the U.S., and the world with virtual peer-to-peer webinars, followed by Q&As.
When we talk about our experiences with people who are younger than us or our peers, they just feel better and they feel like reassured about the future. People really appreciate that we're doing this, especially in the pandemic.
Covering relevant topics like competitive culture, dealing with stress and anxiety, and managing time when learning from home.
About different strategies such as sleep schedules, managing priorities, the divide and conquer strategy, study methods, and how to take productive breaks.
They've promoted their events through social media, word of mouth, and forums like Nextdoor. 85 students hopped in on their first webinar in July.
Even though it was on Zoom, it was very interactive.
Their most recent one drew in over 100.
We noticed there's a lot of research and literature behind the positive effects of peer mentorship as it, like, alleviates stress and anxiety.
And this group's actually just getting started. They're planning a virtual summit for January, tailored for those with an interest in engineering, even planning to get guest speakers from those big companies like Qualcomm and Google. Reporting for ABC 10 News, Vanessa Paz.